different ways this can be interpreted. I want to show you how I do these and a fun variation you can use to make this into kind of a traveling move. First off, here's how I do a basic sandbag burpee. Now notice I'm using Ultimate Sandbag Power Bag. It's not a huge bag, but you can put a pretty good amount of weight in it. Right now, this one's about 25 pounds. It has rice in it, actually. Thai rice was on sale that day. If I slam this into the ground too hard, I will want Thai food, so I'm gonna not do that. Anyway, you can also, of course, use sand. At the time, I was in Florida, and all the sand was always wet at Home Depot, which would be much heavier. So use dry sand, or you can use rice. The rice is gonna be a little bit less mobile, but in a bag this size, it's not really going to matter as much. How I started doing these was my friend and I like to work out on concrete, and we wanted to do push-ups on our knuckles, but not so much on concrete. This provides a nice place for your hands. It's in a nice soft sandbag. Now you are going to have to balance on it. So with every plus, there is a challenge. Here we go. I start by standing, drop it down, kick my legs back, push up, and now I fling it up top, land it on my hands. This will take you some practice if you haven't done it before. We really liked doing these across an empty parking lot, almost as a race. And if you have a small group class that's a little competitive, this can be a lot of fun. You have to use a little bit of the honor system though, because you're gonna have to take three steps. You're gonna take one, two, three. One, two, three. That was kind of a short step, but you know what I mean. Whew! These add up fast. So about halfway across that parking lot, it got very interesting. You can also do two steps, or one step if you're really mean, or if you only have a small area to work in. So, have fun, and try these in the workout that's linked below. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe.